Hey, yo, what is going on? But once again, ladies and gentlemen, fanboys and fangirls, bros, women, and of course, as always, otakus, niki, gamotis out there, this is Mr. Nintendo Sony Free 2011, aka Manny Wolverine. Of course, you guys are wrestling intros and outros towards this channel. Follow me on Twitter and Instagram, all the other good stuff. And today, my friends, actually, it's about a day or two ago when this happened, but I still really, really want to talk about Sony PlayStation related. I've been talking since like probably August and this month, September, for the past 2 months. And it's just been a shit ton of news about Sony, a lot more than normal. Because most of the time, I usually talk about sometimes on Microsoft and like the Xbox One X, along with a little bit of Nintendo Switch news occasionally here and there, and a lot of anime, Japanese manga news as well. And once in a while, some occasional like internet news. But today, it looks like Sony, or actually no, yesterday or a day and a half ago, if you want to be more specific, Sony, they're finally doing cross-platform shit. Even though, granted, I don't really care too much about the game Fortnite, they're doing it for Fortnite because, you know they screwed up. They shot themselves in the foot when they said, oh, Sony's the best console to play, the best place to play. Screw that shit. Not always. It's always that or Nintendo. So that's why I like both the consoles half the time, Nintendo and Sony. That's my username. But yeah, I found this news through Twitter on Kotaku's little, like, Twitter official handle there. And then this one right here, this golden wireless headset shit. Looks pretty fucking good. I'm loving it, so, the words of McDonald's, I'm fucking loving it. I swear to God, I'm not getting sponsored by those dudes. But anyways, Luke Plenter is the one that wrote this article, so it says, having registered, and this is Sony's finally allowing crossplay for the PS4. Having resisted for so long, Sony's finally given up at crossing and allowing crossplay for the PS4 for selected third-party content, meaning that PS4 owners, PlayStation 4 owners, we'll soon get to play the same game against people on competing consoles. In a blog spot, Sony posted, and this is, I guess, from one of the CEO companies for Sony Japan or the one for here in the United States. I don't know which one it is, but this is some great, amazing, excellent-ass news, and I'm really happy. They finally caved in and, like, gave in to the fans. It's about fucking time, man. Start listening to what your fans got to say, Sony. I'm just saying. This is following a comprehensive evaluation process. SIE, I guess that's Sony Interactive Entertainment, I think that's what it is, identified a path towards supporting cross-platform features for selecting third-party content. We recognize that the PS4 players have been eagerly awaiting an update, and we appreciate the community's continued patience as we have navigated through the issues of a solution. That sounds like a really huge PR, like, scripted sort of response. But you know what? I'm going to give them the benefit of the doubt and make sure this shit actually lasts. Hopefully. All right, let's move forward. So it says that, that path being said today, with an open beta for Fortnite, and I don't really talk about that much Fortnite news at all, period, because I don't really care for the game. I'm more of a player known battlegrounds person than I am with Fortnite, I'm just saying. At Fortnite, that'll pass without let PS4 players go up against people on the Xbox One, Switch, PC, Mac, and mobile. And perhaps an admissions as to why this has taken so long when the competition has allowed it for ages. Sony adds that, quote, this represents a major policy for our SIE, unquote. And said that there'll be more information on other titles going forward when we have more details to share. Fair enough. Fair fucking enough, Sony. You keep doing your thing. Don't let the trolls screw you over. I'm just saying. Oh, and I gotta give a real quick special shout out to my boy Andrew, or aka no better known as Crystal Fisher. He actually ended up getting a freaking bachelor's degree in media. I think it was like media entertainment. Shout out to my freaking boy. He's awesome, man. Crystal Fisher, my boy. Oh man. Well, shout out to him, man. If any people don't want to follow me, he's the one I usually get a lot of Spyro and Crash news from half the time. But shout out to my boy. He's awesome, man. He's almost like a Australian brother to me. He's awesome. So yeah, congrats on that bachelor's. You must have busted your ass tooth and nail to get that. I know, because I remember I got a long time ago at this like associate's degree for computer stuff, so I know how hard it is that shit is to achieve a beautiful goal like that. Alright, let's move on. Just try not to get too sidetracked. So it says it would make sense that it is a policy to be it has been a policy challenge rather than a technical one. Since crossplay between PS4 and Xbox One was accidentally turned on last year before being quickly disabled. It says update 1206. We have reached out to the major third parties to see if their games will be start incorporating PS4 into their crossplay play offering. Psyonix, I think that's what they're called. Makers of the Rocket League game, currently allows cross players between Xbox One, Switch, and PC. They sound into it, but say we should ask Sony about this. Their statement from the studio vice president, Jeremy Dunham, says, quote, "We are really happy for PlayStation and Fortnite communities and think that this is a great step forward. We know that Rocket League players and our own community want to know what this means for them as well. But we don't have any updates at the moment. In the meantime, we recommend reaching out to PlayStation directly for any further comments," unquote. Sounds like some pretty like secret information news they don't want to share, Rocket League. Come on, you got to give us some good scoops of what you're going to do, whether you're going to collab with them or not. It's inevitable. They got to collab with them. If they don't, that's kind of a little bit of a kick in the nuts there, if you ask me. Let's move on. We've asked Sony, and we will keep readers posted about any cross-console multiplayer news that we hear about. Update 219. Asked about possible cross-console plays for Rocket League and a host in of other games, a Sony rep told Kotaku, "We have no plans to announce this at this point, but our goal is to remains to take a more open stance with cross-platform support that's aligned with our mission to deliver the best consumer experience," unquote. And here's an Activision Blizzard rep. If any people don't know what rep is right here, rep is just a shorter like word for representatives. I'm pretty sure what that is, or one of the ambassadors. I don't know. Replying to the questions about any plans for Destiny and Black Ops crossplay platforms, play with PlayStation, are presumably the Overwatch and Diablo inquiries, which were posted to Blizzard PR as well. I'm not really crazy about a lot of Blizzard games, except for Diablo. It's probably the only one I really give a shit about. And Overwatch is pretty decent, too. Only one I never care for, I know it's the biggest one of their franchises, World of Warcraft. That shit just puts me to sleep. I have zero interest, zero tolerance on that, and I really don't give a fuck about it. I'm sorry for anyone that's a really big PC person that was into World of Warcraft, but the thing is, when I was a 90s kid, I was way too poor to get a freaking computer. I was able to get the console, but not the computer. But yeah, so it says, or my fam was at the time, my uncle did. So it says, "We've had great experiences with crossplay from Hearthstone and other platforms, and I've witnessed how compelling it can be for our community. There's still a lot of work to do, and both sides of the platforms said to understand whether crossplay might be integrated into our other games. So we'll be watching at the upcoming tests and and we'll assess," I thought it said asses, "assesses what potential impact this feature would be for our players and our games," unquote. Take-Two had nothing to share at this time regarding its 2K games. Same with Microsoft on rep Minecraft. "Here's a rep of Microsoft. We would love to bring our players on Sony PlayStation 4 into our Minecraft ecosystem as well, but we have nothing further to share at this time." A lot of this stuff is probably like secret stuff under oath. They got to keep like an oath under contract sort of thing. Like, they got to keep everything on the down low. I understand, because if they do, their jobs and their career and their life, their fucking whole life is on the line. If they say anything at all, their life could be fucking ruined. Their name and their reputation could be really, really screwed over and end up having a real bad negative impact on their businesses and a lot of their marketing stuff. I see why they want to keep it on the down low and a little bit of the hush hush, because you know, they want to have all the consumers and the fans out there surprised to see what goes down with Sony's cross-platforming news. And this is a pretty big-ass, huge, not detrimental, but like a huge, giant, what's it called? Not practice of a huge event in video gaming history. This is what I see in video gaming history. This is turning the tables. It's a huge cataclysmic event that's going down, people. Witnessing history. Getting, like, not repeated, but, like, rewritten in our own very eyes. That's how I'm seeing it. So, here it is. That's like when Microsoft and Nintendo decided to, like, do, like, a cross-platform thing with Minecraft. That's a big-ass step in a really cool direction. So it says, I'm not sure, Andrew Mason, shout out to him for making this one. It says, Golden Wireless Headsets White Edition launches in December. We are thrilled to announce that, and this is from their official PlayStation blog, so this is coming from their company, their own representations. Pleased to announce, or thrilled to announce, that the white edition of Gold Wireless headsets will be available from the 13th of December across Europe, just in time for the holidays. Available alongside the black version, both models offer the same enhanced comfort and performance with stunning 7.1 virtual sound effects, dual noise canceling microphones, and a refined, extra durable design. I gotta get a drink. My voice is starting to run out. It's way better. A great audio experience, vitality is vitally important to completely immerse yourself in a gaming session. So we're happy to announce more games with their own custom audio modes available exclusively through the PS4 headset companion app for both the Gold and Platinum wireless headsets. These audio mods tuned by the developers themselves let you experience the games developers intended, dive into densely populated jungles, markets, and bustling city hubs. With Shadow of the Tomb Raider available now, War Relief for the iconic sound of the Dragon Realms for Spyro Reignited Trilogy from November 13th. That's going to be a good-ass suggestion to have that. Their strategy is good when they do this stuff on the holiday. I'm telling you, man, the weekends and vacations. Whatever you guys celebrate, let's move on. Okay, I already read that. In addition, more games are set to support 3D audio. Our enhanced deep immersion audio features for the Platinum wireless headset. Look forward to an incredible new RPG experience with EA's Anthem and a brutal test of survival in Days Gone. For those wanting the headsets of $500 million limited edition golden wireless headset, there's not long to wait with them to release this in just 2 weeks, on the time of October 11th. Created the commemoration and an incredible milestone in the PlayStation history, the specially designed features of the dark blue translucent ear cups with contrasting copper details. Let us know in the comments what you think of the new white additional headsets in which the upcoming audio modes you'll be excited to experience. Overall thoughts and opinions. I like the dark black gold ones a lot better. These were the ones on that translucent console for the PS4 and PS4 Pro came out. This is my freaking jam. This looks really, really good. Absolutely love the shit out of this design. It's got that gold PlayStation logo on the bottom. That looks epic as fuck, man. That looks really, really freaking good. I would love to have this shit in my collection. I really hope to God it's not $500 million. There's no way in hell I'll ever be able to afford that in my lifetime. Unless you guys are millionaires or billionaires out there that are secret about that, and you can probably get 10 or 20 of those if you want, let me know. I would love to get the hookup on that and like try to review that on my channel. That would be real nice to do an unboxing video for that. There's probably like thousands of other videos of channels that have done videos on that before. Look at that shit. That is sexy. I love it. It's amazing. That being said, that's all I'm going to say for now. I'm done here. I'll link the description box down below to the Kotaku News on the Twitter account down below, and I'm out. Peace sells out once again, ladies and gentlemen, bros, women, fanboys, and fangirls. And of course, as always, Otakus and Niki Komodis out there. I will see you when I see you guys. Have a good day, have a good night, wherever you are in the universe out there. Don't drink, swim, wood at the same time. Don't do the reckless. Keep it calm, keep it cool, keep it chill, keep it like out there. Stay tuned for future articles, session reviews, including video game industry news, anime manga news, internet news, and that wraps it up. So, take it easy, stay safe. Peace out, I'm like sauerkraut. I'm gone and peace out, I'm like sauerkraut. I'm gone and get the hell out of here. Ladies and goodbye. We'll see you all on the flip side. I'm gone. I'm out. Later. See you guys soon. Take it easy and goodbye. Laters.